Hi, my name is Don Zickas, a kernel engineer at Red Hat, and I'm here to talk about the PowerPC 64 Little Indian platform and how you can take advantage of it. IBM's PowerPC platform has been around for a very long time, and it's always been a big Indian architecture. Recently, we've added support for the Little Indian architecture. Big Indian machines store the most significant bit in the smallest address, while Little Indian machines store the least significant bit in the smallest address. If you look at the example on the screen, you see a chunk of memory. Inside the memory, you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Big Indian reads that as you see it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, whereas Little Indian reads that as 7, 8, 5, 6, 3, 4, 1, 2. Here's a source code to a very simple demo. I've run the program, captured the output, and displayed it here. Looking at the Little Indian output, we see when red is a large number, it is the expected 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But read as bytes, it is reversed. Running it through a BE to host function, the large number is reversed, but the smaller bytes is read as expected. Looking at the Big Indian output, reading as a large number and as a smaller byte reveals the same expected numbers. Running it through the BE to host routine does nothing because, well, the host is already Big Indian, so we see the converted output stays the same. Let's take a moment to talk about how to convert from Big Indian to Little Indian. Going back to the source code, up top, see the routine BE to host. What this routine does first is determine if we are on a Little Indian platform or not, and if so, swaps the input integer byte by byte and returns the new converted number. Otherwise, on Big Indian machines, no conversion is done and the new number looks like the input number. Let's fast forward to the real world. You have an application running on x86, reading data off the network. All the Big Indian and Little Indian conversion is done, debugged, verified. Now you want to migrate to a PowerPC Big Indian. To do that, you have to unconvert your data, re-debug problems, and most importantly, re-verify everything works correctly again. With Little Indian, the data stays the same. No conversion back into Big Indian. Very little debugging and re-verification, just a simple recompile and off you go. That's one of the big advantages of the PowerPC Little Indian platform. So what is Red Hat doing with the PowerPC Little Indian platform? Let's dive into another example. I have three windows on the screen. Bottom screen is a PowerPC Little Indian hypervisor running RHEV. And on top of that is a Little Indian guest on the right running RHEL 7 and a Big Indian guest on the left also running RHEL 7. I'm going to rerun the same demo as before, show the same output we saw before, lets you see things in live a little bit. Next, I'm going to run LSCPU on both guests and the hypervisor to show that everything I'm saying is true and no tricks here. Now let's compare packages on both guests. As we can see, the package count is nearly identical, with Big Indian hosting a few more packages. This is RHEL. Everything is the same. The packages, the tools, the interface. We focus on abstracting the hardware, so the user experience is consistent on whatever hardware you invest in. We've been supporting PowerPC Big Indian for a long time. It's a mature and stable platform. We're now introducing the Little Indian variant, the same stability you expect. For those folks with the Little Indian applications and were holding off migrating to a Big Indian platform, we now provide you a path forward to another Little Indian platform if that hardware solves your needs. Just a simple recompile, no messy conversions, very smooth transition. We believe this is a huge advantage of the PowerPC Big Indian platform and encourage folks to take a serious look at this new platform we are offering support for. Thanks for listening, and I hope you learned a few advantages the PowerPC Little Indian platform can provide for your business.